All right, it is seconds away from meeting a pop culture icon.
Watch out, guys. Come on. Where are we going?
We're
going to
Gate 2.
Where is Gate 2?
Awaiting us, an exclusive journey behind the scenes of Lady Gaga.
Oh, those are the little monsters. All right, ready to go?
Okay, guys, so we're going to go down to production.
Sure, okay.
And then just kind of wait there.
After you.
This elevator leads to the bowels of a jam-packed arena, to my date with the one and only. And finally, we cross the threshold from reality to Gaga Land.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go. All right, come on, now watch it. Watch the steps.
To see where she prepares, where she writes her chart-topping hits, to meet the woman herself.
And have you seen that her videos? Like, all the iconic stuff's in there, right?
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah. Check, check, check. 1, 2. 1, 2, check. Ready? All right.
Still rolling.
Okay, in 3. Lady Gaga is arguably the most creative, the most talked about, the most controversial pop star on the planet. And tonight, our cameras will take you where no one else can, into the world, into the mind of Gaga. All right, she's coming. For a minute.
From backstage to our exclusive sit-down, we dive headfirst into all things Gaga.
I hate perfection. I think it's the flaws in myself and the flaws in the world, the flaws in my fans that precisely make them beautiful.
Her meteoric rise to superstardom.
Once you start to get, you know, a little bit famous, you start to think you have to conform to something or some idea of what people are projecting onto you.
Becoming an icon of a movement.
If you don't like it, go home.
I can't explain to you my relationship with the gay community because even I don't understand it. It's like I've always had gay friends. I grew up with a culture of people that were blind to color, race, religion.
We go one-on-one with the biggest name in pop music.
I honestly think that you are someone different. I think you are something different. I don't think that there's anybody out there like you.
Thank you.
And dispel the controversy over her brand new disc, Born This Way.
I think pretty much with everything I put out, everyone always makes me explain myself. And I think it was an interesting transition for me with Born This Way because up until this point, the most controversial thing about me has been what I say in interviews and what I wear. And the music has, in a lot of ways, been the less controversial thing about me. And I've now transitioned into making more controversial music, which was a very quick and very jarring transition. And I don't think it's going to stop after Born This Way. I think at the end of the day, it's just a really massive pop song, which is the most important.
Is it technically out of you yet, or do you still have to birth some other stuff?
No, it's absolutely not out of me. I call what I do art pop. Because I'm like a painter with the way I think about music. I mean, I actually, when I'm writing music and when I'm producing, I co-produced and I wrote every song on this album. When I'm making music, I see it like a wall, and it's like I'm painting. The bass line is over here, and then I put the bells up top, and then I put the vocal right here, and sometimes it goes here, and it's like I'm part of every process, the mixing process. You know, especially with electronic music, we make all our own sounds. It's really important to me, especially since dance music has now become the like trend, to be really honest in the kind of dance music that I'm making. And I know artistically that from Born This Way to the end of the album, it's completely artistically fresh and new, and it's exciting.
So, who is Lady Gaga, and how did this 25-year-old New York native become an international pop superstar? Well, it wasn't overnight. Stephanie Joanne Germanotta came from humble beginnings. Her strict Catholic school upbringing forged in her a desire to unleash her artistic ambitions. Early in her career, Gaga landed gigs writing songs for performers like Britney Spears, Fergie, and the Pussycat Dolls, the same musical idols that she would later conquer with her own electro-pop-punk sound. After a decade monopolized by fleeting female stars with forgettable singles, Gaga's official debut would go on to dominate the spotlight. She doesn't cater to the mainstream, but her mass market appeal is undeniable. 5 Grammy wins, 8 top 10 hits, a world tour grossing over 130 million in 28 countries, 14 million albums sold worldwide, and the record for highest selling digital album of all time. Scorned as a young social misfit, Gaga embraces anyone and everyone who has ever felt like an outcast. And that includes her little monsters, the followers who have made her an international superstar. They are a global fan base who worship Lady Gaga and are fiercely protective of their idol. Yet, she's an idol that doesn't take herself too seriously. Gaga enjoys the spotlight, and it shows. Her flamboyant sense of style on stage and off, from bubbles and hair bows to the infamous meat dress, all Gaga originals. Those outrageous outfits and avant-garde looks all contribute to what she deems as beautiful, not what others say is the standard. But it's that sentiment that runs through her latest release, Born This Way. To never compromise, be true to who you are, because, baby, you were born this way.
You know, you talked about the transition into being more controversial and in your face and pushing boundaries. And is the song in and of itself, the name of the song in and of itself, a test for people?
No, I'm not testing anyone. You know, I, at the end of the day, don't really give a f*** what people think about my music or about me. And I think if I did, I wouldn't even be here anymore.
I wouldn't have gotten that from you. I would have just assumed very self-conscious, you know.
Really?
No.
So colorful, really? Yeah, I mean, I got a lot of backlash with Born This Way. It's really kind of this weird feeling when you have this number one worldwide record, the song's number one. It's sold more, faster than any one of my singles. It's got a more emotional reaction from all my fans. It's touched them in a more meaningful way, and yet this enormous backlash occurred. And I thought to myself, well, isn't this exactly the way it's supposed to be? I'm not supposed to be appreciated now. You'll all appreciate me 20 years from now.
In your mind, are you envisioning doing that in front of a crowd?
When I write all my records, I'm thinking about the clothes, the hair, I'm thinking about the music video, what it's going to look like, the dancing, the concept. I mean, when I started out with Born This Way, I wrote the song, and as I was writing the song, I thought about the new race. I thought about an alternate planet owned by the government where we could birth a new nation within the nation of humanity. I thought about street kids doing Alvin Ailey modern dance. I thought about the idea of using slime as a representation of womb and us being one giant cell that is a mitosis of the future. I mean, every single thing I do is like this, it's like this giant sort of artistic gobble-gobble in my head that just sort of agonizes and twists and turns until I get it out there. And the most exciting thing about the Born This Way video was when we did the skeleton of makeup with myself and Rico, with the pink hair and the ponytail and the matching suits. It was like, you know, I think people are really hard on me in terms of constantly topping myself, which I'm hard enough on myself. I don't need the world to be hard on me. But I just remember when I saw that setup, I remember I looked at everyone around me and I said, this is helium balloons away from what anyone else is doing.
Rolling, speaking. Audio's good.
My experience with Gaga between the takes is the most telling. I see not a diva, but a collaborator, always checking in with her behind-the-scenes team. And with me, she is very open, even sharing sneak peeks of her new album, but only with the cameras off.
You wouldn't believe the lengths that people go to I actually had to buy, what was it, Wendy? Like, I had to buy about 15 new operating machines for my team, computers, because everybody's emails were getting hacked. So I had to buy everyone new computers without my music on.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so that definitely means we got to turn these cameras
yeah.
off. Okay.
Stopping tape.
And after song.
Let me hear another one.
Yes, please. Cameras off.
After song.
Let me hear, maybe some the mixes are all different on
sure.
here. That wasn't the final.
Should we? Yeah.
Yeah.
It becomes clear Gaga's passion is absolutely genuine. So much so, she risks showtime so we could hear just one more.
Are we going to listen to another
yeah.
song? Or should we?
We actually need, if we can continue on, because we have to get to your show.
Okay, just one more song.
We Sorry.
This is a woman fully in control of her message, yet not your typical star. For instance, she asks to drink from a teacup, but settles for a plain old mug. This is Gaga, one of a kind, but not above her fans. Stay where you are when we return.
I think it's interesting that this is something that travels with her wherever she goes.
We go inside Lady Gaga's recording lair.
I have a lot of ideas during the show before and after. I get really inspired by the fans, which is why I wrote the album On the Road. Since I was a little girl, I used to say my life is music, my life is art. And it wasn't true, but I said it every day over and over again. And I rehearsed and practiced every day. And then one day I woke up and my life was art, my life was music, my life was performance. It's so, like, amazing, and I just have to pinch myself every day. Now it's not really a choice, it's just who I am.
Few have seen where I stand now. The makeshift recording studio that follows Lady Gaga everywhere is the epicenter of all her music.
Those are books I wouldn't even pretend to, there's no way I'm touching those. We hear about the control that she needs over her look and her fashion with the House of Gaga. Well, this is clearly what she needs to maintain control over sort of the music in her head. She needs to be able to put stuff down whenever she feels the need. There's stuff that's never going to see or hear the light of day that's in here. Born This Way lyric. I mean, there are edits in here that are never going to be heard. Stepping stones to songs that will one day become hits.
Gaga's creative process happens here. A self-described, quote, 15-minute vomiting of music genius likely inspired by these images.
I don't want to put words in her mouth, but I'm assuming these are musicians that mean things to her. It's from Motley Crue to Poison. We got the Sex Pistols over here. All sorts of different types of music as well. And then over here is the fan art. This is clearly her desk that she travels with the Beatles, live at the BBC, and Bob Dylan.
Born This Way evolved in simple rooms just like this setup around the world on every stop of the Monster Ball Tour.
I think it's interesting that this is something that travels with her wherever she goes. This is part of her rider. Used to be back in the day, it was no green M&Ms. Well, this is what she needs to get through a day and to live on the road. 20 years from now, 30 years from now, 40 years from now, when sort of the Lady Gaga of today is but a memory, that could be an exhibit in something that looks like a museum. I mean, that's what it felt like in there. What about backstage? We were allowed to look around and see the environment in which you prepare for the show and you get ready. I went into a room that was sort of like a recording studio, and I saw some computer equipment and some speakers, but I also saw a desk. And on the desk were these what looked like two antique maybe journals or diaries, and they were laid out, I guess, awaiting your arrival. Can I ask, what do you put in there?
I have a lot of ideas during the show, before and after. I get really inspired by the fans, which is why I wrote the album On the Road. And I often will, like, literally stop in the middle of the quick change and look over at my House of Gaga's backstage with me, and I often look over and I'll say, remember this, write this down. I'm just sort of screaming and yelling because I can't hear because it's so loud. So we have these journals kind of sitting around for me when I get creative. I write music backstage. I write it in my bed. Actually, a lot of the songs on this record, I actually write in my sleep. I know that sounds crazy, but I actually dream melodies and lyrics all the time, and then I just have to wake myself up. And have you ever done that, waking yourself up from a dream?
Yeah, but I can never remember it.
Well, I do.
Yeah.
And if I don't remember it, I just sort of try to simply say to myself, well, it wasn't that good anyway.
So you wake up and you sing it into something?
I sing it into my BlackBerry, and then I'll inevitably call, like, Fernando or White Shadow or Red One, and I'll say, come to my room, and it'll be 4 a.m., and they'll just be like, what's going on? And I'll just hold the phone out, and they'll take it from me, and then they'll get to work.
Inspiration can strike this megastar at any moment, backstage, on the road, even in bed. And for Lady Gaga, it's the secret to her success. breaking onto the scene with The Fame. Gaga's debut disc established her as music's next big name and helped lay the groundwork for her to become one of the best-selling artists of all time. Blending glam rock idols with her love of 80s icons, Gaga's own brand of pop rock was poised to take over the world. And while topping the charts time and time again with addictive hit tracks was never Gaga's ambition, it's what happened. And it solidified her as a global pop phenomenon whose every move from that moment on would be watched by millions. With only two albums under her belt, Lady Gaga has earned an amazing 12 Grammy nominations and 5 major award wins. Pushing boundaries and buttons, her catchy yet controversial videos have ushered in a whole new era for Lady Gaga. Now comes her most controversial video to date. Playing a love-torn Mary Magdalene, pining for both Jesus and his traitorous disciple Judas, Lady Gaga has moved from pop star to cultural phenom. The 7-minute-long video was co-directed by Gaga and her longtime creative director, Lorianne Gibson.
I wanted just the message to be about releasing the things you don't like and finding the things that you love.
I saw on your desk you had a Beatles picture and a Bob Dylan picture. What do those things mean? Are they inspiration for you?
Yeah, I mean, those artists are my biggest inspiration. I always think it's funny when people say her music sounds so retro. It's like, was it ever not retro? I mean, I still call myself a retrosexual all the time, you know? I'm so obsessed with music from the 70s and the 80s, and now a little bit of the early 90s as well. Just the freedom and there was sort of this like psychedelia in music, whether it was disco or it was rock and roll or it was jazz, everything just got really exciting and really free. And those artists keep me strong because I remember that they lived during a time and were big during a time when the internet wasn't running the music business. So I just, whenever I get insecure, a little bit nervous, or not sure about things, I watch an old Bob Dylan interview, because they were never affected by anyone's negativity, because they just knew who they were. And I know who I am. It's just there's so much more negativity all the time that I have to put up my Gaga shield.
Keep it locked after the break.
I remember that. That's the bra that lights on fire.
We get our fashion fix with the House of Gaga.
It's really cool when the people that you work with just get you.
And later in the show, only we're with Gaga right before she hits the stage.
Well, I didn't name myself Gaga. My producer, he said I was very theatrical when I performed.
Yeah.
So he would say, you're so Gaga. And one day I said, you mean like the Queen record? And he goes, yeah. You're like Freddie Mercury. You have to live and breathe your art. And if you don't, you won't get anywhere. And that's, I got here by working very hard. And that's what The Fame is really about.
Hey, Ben, how are you? There's one more thing you gotta see.
All right, wait, hold on a second. Like, every seat in the house and every place she goes, full.
The religious experience that is a Lady Gaga concert begins backstage.
This is...
And this is the no man's land, but we're gonna give you a sneak peek.
And in a tiny room with a big purpose.
All right, so this is where...
This is the Gaga quick change.
This quick change, so she's in here 13 times a show.
That's it.
I have to say, it's the least glamorous thing. I was picturing something totally different. Wow.
Most people don't get a chance to see this.
It's here that Gaga's mind-blowing and trend-setting costumes call home. A gold mine of Gaga's brilliant fashions, past, present, and futuristic.
This is one of the most fabulous costumes, the House of Gaga dress that she wears for paparazzi, which... takes 4 people to get on.
Listen, I know on stage it looks flawless. You can tell it's been through more than one concert.
I've been on this tour for a year, and we've been using it on a consistent basis, so it begins to show a little bit of wear. Giorgio Armani Privé for Bad Romance.
Okay, hypothetically, if you had to get her out of this and into that, in the quick change, how quick does that happen?
We could do it. We could do it in 60 seconds if we had to.
And then, of course, is this. I remember this.
Or Love Game.
I remember that. That's the bra that lights on fire.
Yes, that's it. Sparks. That's a showstopper, too.
That is a that's exactly what it is.
From here, it's just steps to the bright lights and tens of thousands of adoring little monsters.
Do you want to walk her path?
Yes, I'd love to.
So she does her changes here.
Yeah.
Very quickly, comes back out of the quick change, up the steps, and into Gaga Land.
It's hard to wrap your head around.
Land of make-believe.
It's unbelievable. This one is unbelievable. And so the people that you travel with, all the people in this room, this is your family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're really beautiful people. Yeah. And nobody pushes me. You know, we have a really loving relationship. I'm sure people love to create an idea of what they think that I am, some drug abusing, diva, but it's really not at all what it's like. It's more of a artistic factory than it is a party.
Well, you said earlier that you could wake yourself up and you can be thinking of music or a beat or a tune or a melody. Do you ever wake up with an image of something that you might want to design fashion-wise?
Yeah, all the time.
And so you sketch that out as well?
Sketching, I'll tell someone, call someone, do this, make that, yeah.
I think the way I see it now is that Lady Gaga can do, can say, can sing, and can indeed wear anything she wants. The definition of what like for me, what I'm wearing right now, is this too narrow a definition? Because clearly your definition
is
broader.
What you just said, you said to me you can be, do, say, wear, sing, write, whatever you want to. Mm-hmm. So can you, Ben.
I like wearing this.
That's right, and that you were born this way.
Merging music and fashion comes easy for this icon, and nowhere was that more noticeable than during Paris Fall Fashion Week, where Gaga made her runway debut for the House of Mugler. Teaming with personal stylist and designer Nicola Formichetti, it quickly became one of the most highly anticipated shows when word spread that she would be making an appearance.
Well, here at Mugler, I guess Lady Gaga is going to be performing, or going to be in the show. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm excited.
I love her. She's a remarkable woman, gracious and generous and just gifted to a fault. So I think the evening's going to be really exciting.
And Gaga did not disappoint. Strutting her stuff, the pop star thrilled onlookers, and Formichetti's debut collection for Mugler was heralded as a success.
I love the show. I thought it was incredible. Super inspiring and made me happy.
When you work in collaboration with other designers, do you ever have an idea that gets shot down? Do you ever say, I'd like to do this? And they say, that's not a good idea.
Yeah, of course I do. Or they, or vice versa. You know what's really funny is, I don't know if you saw the Mugler show. Oh, it was so fun. It was a dream come true for me. I said, if I can be 5'3" and walk down this runway, it will be a triumph for my fans all over the world. Because it's sort of, being a runway model is like the ultimate glamour. And I have worshipped Mugler for so long. But what's really funny is I dyed my bangs black about, 4 days before the Mugler show. And I pulled into Paris and I got on the phone and I called up Nicola and I was speaking to, the Mugler, House of Mugler. And I said, so what's I've seen the clothes, what's the hair? What are we doing for the look for the show? And they go, well, it's a black bang. And I was like, it's like, yeah, it's the zeitgeist. It's so rad when stuff like that happens. And then I arrived and, the bangs, it was blonde hair with black bangs. And it was just, it's really cool. And the people that you work with just get you. The House of Gaga and I, we just make work for each other because we know that we represent the spirit of the little monsters.
Do you always wear what is 100% you, or do you have people you collaborate with who say, well, just try this, see if you'll like this?
No, it doesn't really work that. No, it's really just what I want to wear, and it just has to be right, and it's Everybody always laughs because I'll get like racks of designer clothing sent to me, yeah. And then I'll end up coming out here in a leather bra that cost me $10 and some, yeah, but actually they're mini pair of shoes, so I can't complain too much. See my Born This Way earrings?
What did they say?
They say Born This Way.
Was there ever a moment, is there a moment in your mind you can remember where there was a fork in the road and you said, I could go this way and conform, or I could go this way and be the person we
Absolutely.
See today?
Absolutely, of course there
and
was.
Did you struggle with that?
I don't like believing or knowing or thinking that beauty is something that the world tells me is beauty, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
I don't like anyone else having their projection onto me of when I look my most beautiful. Mm-hmm. I like to have the control of being able to say, this is beautiful. Something about putting on makeup, doing my hair, putting on lipstick. It's my way of saying beauty is something that is inside of you that you project. It's not about society's idea of what beauty is. And I guess that's my way of answering your question is Hollywood. You know, you watch a red carpet. I hate red carpets. That's why I did the vessel on the red carpet on the Grammys. I didn't want to talk to anybody. I hate it.
Yeah.
Everything looks the same. And then I'm the one who gets, you know, stoned because I have something to say.
Right.
Once you start to get, you know, a little bit famous, you start to think you have to conform to something or some idea of what people are projecting onto you. What Born This Way is all about is you're going to project your idea of you onto the world. It's not about the world telling you who you are. It's about you telling the world who you are.
Up next, fans go gaga for Lady Gaga.
And Gaga. Do anything for her.
How her little monsters have impacted the music superstar.
I'm not looking to be worshipped by the world. I want to worship my fans. I basically told Much Music that if they couldn't build my subway train, that I was going to blow my up on stage. And so we prepared to blow my up, and then they built my subway train. So I did both.
What you're wearing is, I mean, it's typical Gaga.
No, typical.
Not typical.
Punch you.
No, please don't. Or maybe yes. Oh, no.
You might like it.
You will about Lady Gaga's legion of little monsters, they've made her one of the most powerful artists alive.
Gaga. We'd do anything for her. Anything for her.
I've been here since
when? Yeah, we've been here since 9:30. It's what you do for the love of music.
But what I see here outside Toronto's Air Canada Centre minutes before the curtain rises is just a taste. Online, the numbers paint a bigger picture. Over 33 million like her fan page on Facebook.
Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to get this crazy, googly Lady Gaga eyes.
And meet makeup artist and fan, Michelle Phan. She created these YouTube videos replicating Gaga's iconic looks and landed nearly 50 million views.
I'm beautiful in my way.
Winnipeg's Maria Aragon posted a cover of Born This Way and earned herself 31 million hits and some FaceTime with her mentor. And the top Twitter account, not Obama, not Bieber, Gaga, with nearly 10 million followers. The fans themselves will tell you why Lady Gaga has become their queen.
Her philosophy just completely struck me that it doesn't matter how much money you have in your pocket or who you are or what color skin, anyone can be famous in their own way and change the world. And that just struck me.
Let's talk about the things that you have to say, because you've got music and there's the art involved and there are your fans and they have things that are important to them. There are issues that you bring up and there are issues that you represent, from, you know, personal empowerment to gay rights. And it occurred to me, if you had come around 5 years earlier, the issue of gay rights would not be at the forefront where it is. It seems like the perfect marriage of time and person, an issue in person. Did you know that you were coming up against it?
My parents are really wonderful people, and they always taught me to be really loving and giving. So part of that is my upbringing, and then the other part of it is just that I think this is my destiny. And I can't explain to you my relationship with the gay community, because even I don't understand it. It's like I've always had gay friends. I grew up with a culture of people that were blind to color, race, religion, just no prejudice, really free. So I just want to.
Yeah.
You have no idea how much in the beginning of my career people were saying, don't you think you should have less gay dancers on stage? Don't you think that you should make this put more girls in the show? Don't you think that it should be less gay and more, you know, appeal to more people? Why don't we put this single out because you'll get new fans? And I just said, I don't want new fans. I like my fans. I don't need new, you know, if you don't like Born This Way, if you don't like Bad Romance, if you like Poker Face, but you don't like, you know, my fans love it. And that's all that matters. I'm not looking to be worshipped by the world. I want to worship my fans. I don't want to be your queen.
What is the end goal for you? Have you thought about that?
I don't take any credit for anything political that has passed. I just wanted to be involved and help use my position as a public figure to make people aware of the injustices that have been going on. That's what that scene is from Born This Way. You know, when I give birth to the machine gun, and then I cock the gun in front of the new race that's below me as we're going down to the black earth, which is where we all live now. I'm holding the gun, and you see the race all behind me, because I'm saying now that we've created something so perfect, which is, in essence, my fans. In essence, I'm giving birth to my fans in the video. How do I protect this? How do I protect this forever? So I guess that's what I'm focusing on right now. I want to protect the precious and the perfect thing that is Little Monster.
She'll go away.
She needs to feel at home. She needs to feel quiet. I mean, there's a definite sense of quiet here.
Coming up, we get a rare glimpse of Gaga's world, and I share an unforgettable moment with the lady herself.
Oh. Me and my thong just assaulted you.
There's still more to come when Lady Gaga, Born This Way, an E! Talk primetime special continues.
I am wearing a latex pantsuit that is inspired by condoms, because today we are going to talk about safe sex. There seems to be this sentiment among young people, which I really, really noticed as I traveled the world last year. There's so many people that think, I won't get HIV. I would never contract AIDS. When, since 1985, the number has tripled in women who are infected every day by HIV. The same for men. AIDS is 100% preventable, but 0% curable.
Here we go. So we're going into Lady Gaga's dressing room.
What was an NBA dressing room transforms into Gaga's refuge. Here she dresses and warms up for showtime.
All right, so the dressing room is the sanctuary. Can you show me some of the things you got
in
the rack here?
This is the first look of the night, the latex leotard.
So this, yeah, okay, top of the show.
This is the very first look, yeah.
Can I? Oh yeah, that really is. That really?
Not many people have one of those.
No, that's full on rubber.
The leather jacket, very heavy, designed by Hasso Gaga, Nicola Formichetti, and Lady Gaga.
Yeah, this is a classic look, huh?
Totally rhinestone.
What else do we have here?
These are just like after show robes that she likes a little bit of glamour and, you know, like old school.
See, you know, when I guess a few years ago I interviewed her at the MMVAs and I asked her a question. I said, you know, Lady Gaga must on a day off, she must just wear sweats. But
I don't think that's
the case. Now, after watching her for the past 2 years, this is really her all the time. Here's what I'm seeing here. This is normally where athletes hang out. There's a sense of light. It's airy here. I mean, you know, you've got the cream colored walls. Here, check this out. Classic Gaga. See? The teacups.
Drinking from China cups makes Lady Gaga feel, quote, grounded, and reminds her of her daily tea time with mom. The walls speak of a woman with a deep respect for her friends and fans.
She needs to feel at home. She needs to feel quiet. I mean, there's a definite sense of quiet here. There's also a lot of fan art. Friends on the walls from the Elton John, I think other musicians. You saw John Lennon over there. And over here you got Kiss. I think, I don't know if it's for inspiration.
I think that's Sting. This is a room befitting one of pop music's most elusive superstars. But we do find one glimpse of the regular girl inside.
She's got a gym over here. That wants to keep toned on stage and, oh, and these are her shoes, by the way. She's a, let's see. She's probably a size 6 lady's shoe. That's probably the most normal shoe Lady Gaga owns. I've never seen a relationship between a crowd and a musician. And I've never seen a love that went both ways. I mean, I actually believe that that's what I saw. And, you know, as big as it was, I felt it was very intimate. And I thought that you were letting people into a place that a lot of musicians don't let people into. And I honestly think that you are someone different. I think you are something different. I don't think that there's anybody out there like you. And I think in the 2 hours of the concert yesterday, I think I saw that. And,
What? Thank you.
Oh, I'm going to
try a little bit.
Me and my thong just assaulted you.
I have no problem with that. okay, so talk to me about that then, because I was able to go backstage, spend a little time back there in your sort of sanctuary. What does it mean for you to be able to take this music that already means so much to you and then do something with it like the Monster Ball?
It means everything. That's all I want to do. I went actually completely bankrupt after the first leg of the Monster Ball that everyone in Canada saw. The Monster Ball that we did last night has never been done in Canada before. The original Monster Ball was a theater tour, and it was a completely different stage, a different story, the whole thing. And I remember I told my manager, Troy, because him, my business manager, called me and they said, if you do this stage, if you do this tour, you're going to be $3 million in debt. And I said, just keep me on the road.
Yeah.
I said, I'll work it off. Let me work it off. And I was in quite an incredible debt, and I was bankrupt. I had no money. But it was funny because I never even talked about it or thought about it. And my father would call me and he would be like, you're the biggest pop star in the world and you have no money. And I don't understand. And I just said, Dad, just trust me. Just trust me. And, you know, I really don't do this for the money. And I really don't do it for the fame. I do it now for the love of the fans, for my love for the fans, for the relationship that we have. It is stronger than anything in my life. They're my family. So to share this music with them and to create a show that means something to them, that's the most important thing to me.
In moments.
Tens of thousands of fans. Can you feel their energy
it's
yet?
20,000.
20,000. Can you feel that already? Oh.
Only we walk the final steps with Gaga seconds before showtime and rock out to an eye-popping live stadium performance. All this when Lady Gaga Born This Way, an E-Talk primetime special, returns.
That's how I originally became who I am, is in New York City, the downtown scene. I played the piano and would wig out crazy in my underwear. And people were like, who is this girl?
Yeah, totally.
Right, because it's like, she's clearly smart. She clearly knows what she's doing. She's got a killer voice. And she's like in her underwear.
Yeah.
And they would say, you don't need to do that. It's not about needing to do anything. It's what I'm trying to say is you can be a strong woman. You can own your sexuality. And you can still be great.
There are a lot of words that we overuse and then ultimately render useless. Words like groundbreaking and celebrity. But if ever those words hold true, it's for Lady Gaga. As someone who meets and interviews stars the world over, I can say Lady Gaga burns the brightest. She is the most honest, over-the-top, authentic musician around. Her music is from the heart. Her style is all her own.
And when she says she loves her fans, it's not because she wants to sell more concert tickets or albums. It's because she means it. Now, people use a lot of words to describe Lady Gaga, words like freaky, artistic, or iconic. But now, having walked a mile in her unusual shoes, I can report that the woman you see in her videos, on stage and under the microscope, are one and the same. Lady Gaga truly seems born this way.
I can hear it, it's coming. They did sort of like a pre-show cheer.
The long-awaited moment is here. All right, here we go.
Hi.
Enjoy the show.
Wow.
I think there's just one person left.
Such a motley crew of dancers could only precede Gaga.
She's coming. Hi.
Hello.
Thank you for letting us talk
Hello,
to you for a minute.
Talk.
So in just a few minutes, you're going to be out there with tens of thousands of fans. Can you feel their energy
it's
yet?
20,000.
20,000. Can you feel that already? Oh, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I can feel them already. I always can feel them. I feel like I have this really weird sixth sense. Not sixth sense, but sixth sense. It's like my fans are like this disease I don't want to ever recover from. And I can feel them. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for supporting Born This Way. Seeing it number one in Canada is just such a huge honor, and I hope you love our performance as much as I do.
All right, well, listen, we're going to let you go because they're waiting for you. We want to see the show, too. Thanks for letting us walk this far with you, but I'm pretty sure you want to do the rest of this yourself.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You.
Unlike so many others, Lady Gaga makes you dance, but she also makes you think. And whether you love her or hate her, you know who she is. But the most interesting thing about the evolution of Gaga is she is just getting started. We leave you now with a live stadium performance of Born This Way from her Toronto concert from the Air Canada Center. I'm Ben Mulrooney from eTalk. Thank you so much for joining me on this incredible journey with Lady Gaga.
Whether you're broke or evergreen, they show love descent. You're Lebanese, you're Orient. My disabilities have you outcast within your teeth. Choice to love yourself today. Cause baby, you were born this way.